Hi everybody, Dr. Wayne here. Today's video share is on nature and water. Now we're all made up of something called water, about 70% volume, but actually when you look at the molecular H2O, it makes up most of us with a lot of minerals added. And I was just reflecting on my personal journey with cold showers recently and this component of water. You know, it's interesting. Hello. I see some people I know. Hello, hello. And I was challenged by some patients recently who have been doing the Wim Hof method. And to be honest, when I learned what this means, which is cold, freezing cold water immersion, I freaked out. And the reason for that is many years ago, I was trying cold showers because I knew it was a healthy thing to do. And what happened to me back 3 years ago was I got Raynaud's phenomenon. So any of you who knows what that is the fingers go white, right? And it's normal for some people to happen with winter exposure. But the funny thing with me was it wasn't just winter, it was actually being warm. So I would put on my thick coat and drive home in the winter in my car and it would be warm and my fingers would go white. So when this concept of cold showers came and, you know, gelling with water and nature, it freaked me out. So I said, you know, I'm going to look into this. And as usual, I read some stuff. I listened to my patients because, to be honest, they teach me a lot. And I said, right, let's do this. Because the health benefits are amazing. And you can look that up yourself. But what my journey was about was like stepping into the cold shower and thinking, this is not good. This is just not good. And the mind would just kick into, don't do it, don't do it. And because it's a shock, it's like a stress, and your body goes into survival. But the interesting thing was, the reason for the cold fingers is you get constriction, which is narrowing down on the blood vessels. And for me, big arteries, technically, big arteries called digital arteries in the fingers. So the stress would be so much that it would shut them down, and my fingers would go white, and I would literally freak out. But I learned with the exhale breathing. So, like that. You actually dilate the blood vessels. And as a result, you don't get white fingers. Now, the interesting thing for me was, while I was kind of coping with the mental stress of doing cold showers, I had the finger stress. Because after the shower, the fingers would go white. And I couldn't explain it. Like, in the shower, it's freezing. And my fingers would be pink. But out of the shower, I would still do the breathing. And therefore, the fingers would still go white. So I had no idea. Like, really, no idea what that meant. But there must be a connection between the cold exposure and stimulating this vasodilation as well as the breathing. So, you know, this is one half of the Wim Hof method, which I've slowly come to love, especially this weather. You know, in the last few days and weeks, it's been really hot here in BC. And jumping into cold shower first thing in the morning, I find it's easier. And maybe it's because the water's slightly warmer, to be honest. But in the evening, it's a challenge, like, oh my gosh. And how I generally do it is just have a normal temperature, turn it down because I'm used to it. And then at the last minute or so, just go really cold, like, yeah, yank it down. And get that experience. And afterwards, seriously, if you've never done it, try it. It's amazing. You get energy, you get endorphins, you have less stress. If you've got fatigue, like who's not tired when they go to bed, you're waking up. But then it helps you make you sleep, which is an amazing thing, especially in the very hot temperatures of our homes these days. And the other things is we burn brown fat. And brown fat is linked to white fat. Now, white fat is the stuff we've got on this thing, human body, but it's difficult to shift. But the brown fat changes to white fat and literally starts to come off our body. We tone, we lose weight, and we look better. Just with cold showers, isn't that crazy? So, you know, it's funny, I was at the beach this week, as I've been sharing, and I was looking down at my legs, and it was interesting. I was dorsiflexion, which is, say this is your leg right this, okay? This is your leg, and this is your foot. And pulling up the foot so your feet or your toes point towards your head. And I was looking down my leg, and on the inside of the leg, there's the muscle called tibialis anterior, which is just a muscle to pull your foot up. And on the outside, you've got the calf coming in. But I'm going to check. Actually, no. The inside is the calf, sorry. And the outside is the tibialis muscle. But there's a bone called the tibial bone right down the middle. And I couldn't believe it because there was nothing over the bone. Like, wow. So not only are you burning fat all over, but literally you can go down and remove this layer of fat that's everywhere. And you would not believe muscles start popping out that you've never seen before. It's absolutely crazy. So, you know, if you're watching this for the first time and you haven't really looked into this, keep on listening because I'm going to be sharing probably a little bit more about this. You can check me out online. I've done videos. I've done a webinar at my website, waynefimister.com. You can find it under the PIPN. And the second set, I think it's down roughly number 5 or 6, I talk about water for an hour and answering questions or on that subject, and I go into a little bit more detail. But if you would like to learn more about that, or just Google Wim Hof, W-I-M-H-O-F. But that's been a little bit of my personal journey with discovering this amazing treatment, and it is a treatment, and it's now my fourth, you know, the fourth leg of the relay race, as it were, with patients. And I, because all I do these days is help people with pain. So there you go. That's my personal journey with water and cold showers. Thanks so much. Keep being awesome.